So what is up, Africana fam? It's your girl Young Africana back at it again with another video. Today this video is sponsored by Hair VV Hair. I have their Kylie unit in 10 inches and the parting space is 13 by 6. As you guys can see, this wig is already pre-plucked and pre-bleached, as well as having the fake ball cap method underneath, so you don't have to do that underneath, as well as an elastic band. So right now what I'm doing is I'm putting on the wig, and legit, this wig is ready to go and ready to wear. And one thing I really like about this wig is how thin the lace is. I feel like this gave me a flawless install. But right now what I'm doing is I'm just cutting the lace, just because I felt like the lace was a little bit too long and I couldn't see. As I can see, I'm over here filling this pre-plucked hairline. It's perfectly plucked, perfectly bleached. There's no over-bleached knots, no nothing, you guys. So if you're looking for a wig like this, especially for my beginners, this is very, very beginner friendly. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just cutting off the excess lace just to prepare for my install, and I'm just cutting out those air tabs. As you guys can see, this wig fits perfectly snug, so I just cut off the lace. And right now what I'm doing is I'm just tinting the lace to the color of my skin, and I'm using my foundation color, which is the Dior Favorite in the color 9N. And now I'm cutting some ear tabs just so we can work in sections. This install will be a glueless install, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use my Bold Hold Liquid Gold for this install. So I'm just applying that on my forehead. I didn't really clean up my forehead with any alcohol or anything, and it's still stuck. So I went ahead and did two layers. This is my first layer. I'm just using my rat tail comb just to smear it to be a flat consistency on my forehead. And I'm gonna use my blow dryer on warm to get it tacky. And then I'm gonna go ahead and apply another layer, and then blow dry it for like a good 3 seconds. And then apply my lace on to the gel. And now I'm using my eyebrow razor just to cut off the excess lace. You want to make sure that you're cutting in a jagged motion, just so that it doesn't look like it's cut straight across, and overall give you that natural look. And I'm just filling in the pieces that I've missed. And this is pretty much what I'm doing, you guys. It's pretty simple, regular. If y'all my Africana OG, I already know how it goes, okay? But now I'm going on to the ear tabs and like the sides, and I'm just doing the same exact thing. I went ahead and did two layers and then applied the lace onto it. You want to make sure that it's still wet while you're applying the lace onto it, just so that it could adhere better. You don't want to wait for it to fully dry. Alright, so now I'm gonna go ahead and use the blow dryer, and now I'm just pressing that in to the lace. And as you guys can see, this process is super duper simple. And that lace is already melted, y'all. But to further the melt, I'm gonna go ahead and use my Gossipy Free Spray, and I'm going to spray that all over my hairline. Excuse me chomping on some gum, I needed something to chew on. But I'm just spraying that all over my hairline and using my blow dryer just to blow dry that. Now to prep my hair for the hairstyle I'll be doing, I'm using my Karakara wax stick, and I'm just applying that all over my hairline. And I'm just using that just to, you know, tame the flyaways that I have on my hair. And then I'm going in with my hot comb on the hottest setting, and I'm gonna go ahead and hot comb my hairline. And today I'm not really gonna do any baby hairs. I'm just gonna do one on each side of where like my temple is at, and then just have like these long tendrils on like my sideburns. So that's the plan for what I want to do for my baby hairs. And what I'm doing right now is I'm just taking my baby hair and I'm just gonna go ahead and use spritz to set my baby hair. And I didn't cut my baby hairs. I actually ended up cutting them off a little bit later, just a little bit shorter, because I feel like it wasn't swooping the way that I wanted to swoop. But I'm just trying to train my baby hairs, and I'm also going to hot comb those tendrils as well. And now I'm applying my Nairobi setting lotion just to melt the lace even more into my hair. And I feel like this really set the tone for my hair to look extremely melted. And I put my elastic band on my hairline and let that sit for 15 minutes. And after I finished doing that, as you guys can see, it clearly left a little dent. And we went back into my hot comb on the hottest setting. And this hot comb, I know people be asking me for this hot comb. This hot comb is from Amazon. It's the Andes brand. So that's the hot comb that I'm using. And I, like you guys can see, I cut my baby hairs. I didn't show that part because you guys see that all the time. And then I just reformed them. But now on to the makeup. I'm using my Uma Beauty palette. I forgot which palette this was, but this is the red and black palette. And I went into these three colors. I'll be doing this fiery red glitter kind of look. So right now I'm using the darkest red right now as to blow out my crease. And then I'm going into that shimmery shade to apply it onto my eyelids. And now I'm going in to that bright red and I'm just gonna apply that on top. Right now it looks a hot mess, I know, but it ends up looking beautiful later on. So trust the process, y'all. That's all I have to say, because I was even a little bit shook. I'm like, I don't know how this is going to turn out, but we're going to keep on going. And you just want to blend back and forth in between the colors until you get like that blown out look. That was the look I was going for like a blown out look. And it came along. And I went ahead and applied a little eyeliner off camera, but I have my face prepped and primed with the Milk Hydro Primer. And now I'm going into my foundation. I'm using my Dior Forever foundation in the color 9N. And this time I'm going with a beauty blender to blend out my foundation. I kind of wanted a very natural and airbrush kind of look today. You know, I didn't want to go heavy full glam. So yeah, you guys. And now I'm going to my Dior Forever concealer in the color 7N. And I'm applying that all over my face as my first highlighter. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and blend out my beauty blender with my beauty blender. And I'm using my Juvia's Place foundation stick and the color Congo. And I'm just gonna go ahead and buff that out. And then later on buff out that concealer. Now on second concealer, I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape and, you know, my Bitch color. And I'm going to go ahead and use that as my second concealer. And then I'm going to go ahead and highlight my T-zones as well with this concealer. And I'm going in with this small buffer foundation brush. I'm just going to buff out the edges of that concealer just so that we have a nice diffused look. And now going back into that contour stick in the color Congo, I'm gonna go ahead and contour my nose just so we have a snatched look. And then we're gonna go ahead and buff out my concealer. I like to just buff out my concealer last just so that it has a nice concentrated look and it's nice and opaque. And then I went ahead and blended out that that nose contour. And now I'm going into my Benai powder in the color Chestnut to highlight and powder my face. We're gonna bake, you guys. I'm just applying that all over my face where I concealed at. And then I'm gonna go into my Saharan blush palette 2 in the color Abby to contour. And then I'm using my Bare Minerals foundation powder in the color Cocoa just to diffuse that powder. And now going into my Amrezy powder, I am using, the color is Amrezy. And I'm going to use that in my inner tear ducts. And then I went into my White Gold J. LaRue loose powder pigment to apply that just to give it more of a shine. And I put powder underneath my eyes just so it could catch the fallout. And I put my lashes on and everything off camera, and I had my little moles. And now onto the lips, I am using my brown Italia lip liner, and then I'll be using the Lip Bandit. You guys should go ahead and check her out. It's called the Lip Bandit on Instagram. I'm using her lip gloss in the color Coco. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and top that off with the Beauty Supply Store Clear Lip Gloss. And I'm highlighting my nose with the Amrezy highlighter as well. And now I'm spraying my face with my Morphe Luminous Setting Spray. And I'm gonna go ahead and pat that in with my foundation brush. And we are pretty much done with this look. Well, no, not yet, actually. Now it's time to curl my hair. So I wanted to go ahead and do like these nice, you know, I don't know who rocked these curls. I would say Dolly Parton, but I have no idea. But yeah, I just wanted to go for like a nice, you know, 50s kind of look, pinup doll type look, you know. So I went ahead and just added some fringing layers in the front, just so we have some layer action going on. And then I went ahead and curled my hair with my flat iron. And I'm curling in different directions. For the most part, the curls in front of my face are curling outwards from my face. And the other curls are just curling in different directions for the sake of volume, as you guys can see. And I was just kind of all over the place when it came to the curls. I didn't want the curls to be too tight because the hair was already short. But I made it work. Not even gonna lie though, y'all, I was really struggling when it came to these curls, but we made it. So now I'm gonna go ahead and use my paddle brush and just brush out those curls just so I can have them nice and flowing. And now I went ahead and used my razor comb just to cut my tendrils a little bit shorter. And then I'm using my flat iron just to curl it in. And I'm just over here playing with my hair. But overall, these are the finished results. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, subscribe to my channel if you have not. If you have not, what are you doing? Go ahead and subscribe to my channel and turn on those post notifications so you guys can get the drop before the drop even drop. You get me? But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys in the next segment. Deuces!